Hello and welcome everyone. Welcome back. It's a long time since I published a video. I'm starting with Node.js with the Sequelize. There is already existing playlist, but that is not that useful because it has old videos and I wanted to upgrade this particular playlist with Node.js with Sequelize. So in this playlist, we are going to talk about everything about Node.js with the Sequelize. I mean, how you can write a Node.js application with the Sequelize as an ORM. By choosing any of the database, like you can use SQLite, you can use MySQL. So you have multiple choice. So first we will see what is a Sequelize and how this is useful for us. So in Java world or any other programming language, there is always a concept of ORM, Object-Relational Mapping. So like Hibernate is there in Java, which provide ORM, Object-Relational Mapping of database into the classes object, right? Similarly, in JavaScript world, there is Sequelize. There are multiple frameworks available which provides object relational mapping. So Sequelize is one of them. It is also providing the object relational mapping. So whatever we have in the database, it providing the mapping of those database entities in form of class. So we don't have to deal with the MySQL queries and all. You can just access that model object which is provided by Sequelize as a ORM. So myself, Tarun. This is my YouTube channel, and I publish a lot of videos regarding the JavaScript world. So in this particular section, in this particular playlist, we will talk about Sequelize, how to write the application with Sequelize, what is the migrations, what are the seeders, how we can seed the data in the database, how we can write the migrations for the production level application, how we can do the validations, how to write the schema models for the MySQL database, Sequelize database, how to connect to them, and how to use Sequelize efficiently so that we can write an application. We will talk about the relational mapping. There is a one-to-one, one-to-many, many-to-many mappings, all these mappings, how we can manage that in ORM, because now we are not writing the joins and we are not writing the MySQL queries. There is always a pros and cons of using the plain MySQL queries or using ORM. So I will come to that part later. Here we first talk about the Sequelize, and then we will also talk about the advantage, disadvantage if you are using some ORM or you are just writing the plain MySQL queries. Okay, so ORM, yes and no, there is a your choice. If you want the rapid application development, you don't want to write the SQL queries and all, then you can just go ahead with the Sequelize as ORM, because it provides you everything about the data validation before inserting into the database hooks, database validations, seeders, migrations, the schema designing, all these things are being provided by Sequelize. And Sequelize is one of the popular ORM for the Node.js world, because there are not many. The Node.js is now being matured and now other libraries are being introduced, but currently Sequelize is one of the popular one which is being used across the world. Okay, so let's start our journey with the MySQL and the Sequelize, how to write our code. So we'll start our journey with just a simple package.json. So what you need to have these basic packages. We are going to use Express as a web framework for writing the APIs. So first of all, you just need to install MySQL in npm install -- save. MySQL 2 you can install. Sequelize you can install, and Express. These are already there in the package.json. I think I mistake something. Okay, so it will install MySQL 2. Sequelize is an ORM, can be used with the MySQL or SQLite. SQLite is a file-based database. MySQL is a full-fledged RDS, RDBMS system, which can maintain your tables and all these structures. Now, in the second video or going video, further videos, we will talk about how to introduce setup, what are the prerequisites, how to do the basic setup with the Sequelize, how we are maintaining the connection with the MySQL, how we can do the connection pooling and all these things. I mean, when we write the MySQL with the Node.js with the plain, then we use a MySQL as a client, we are getting the connection from this, and then we are just executing queries on top of it, right? So the same kind of thing is just Sequelize is just a wrapper. It is also providing the same kind of connections, giving you the connection object, and you are able to do queries using Sequelize. I mean, you will not be writing the plain queries. You will be just writing or executing some wrapper codes written for the ORM. Okay, let's start our journey for the Sequelize from the next video.